Hello everyone. So previous classes we discussed about the physiological effects of laser, the therapeutic effects and the contraindications and dangers of the laser therapy. Today we'll discuss about the doses of laser therapy. Well, we need to understand the parameters of laser therapy. The first parameter is the wavelength. So we have two types of laser based on the wavelength, the red visible light laser and the infrared laser. So red visible light laser ranges from 630 nanometer to 660 nanometer, and infrared laser ranges from the 780 nanometer to 830 nanometer. So depending upon the depth of the injury or depth of the wound, we will select the type of laser based on wavelength. We know that the red visible light penetrates approximately 1 centimeter depth, and infrared laser penetrates deeper, approximately 5 cm in depth. Second parameter we need to remember is the intensity. Power is joules per second, which is also called as watt. And energy density is the amount of energy falling on a surface, which is expressed in joules per meter square or joules per centimeter square. So the intensity of laser that we use for treating the wounds, low back pain, tendinitis, bursitis, etc. should be given in joules per centimeter square or joules per meter square. So let's discuss here the type of conditions and the expected intensity that can be used for this particular conditions. If it is open wound, then we can opt for visible red laser, and the expected range that we can use, the intensity can be from 0.5 to 1.5 joules per centimeter square. If it is open wound periphery, then we can use intensity of 1 to 4 joules per centimeter square. If it is low back pain, if patient complains of low back pain, we can select red visible light laser with the intensity of 2 to 4 joules per centimeter square. If it is a deeper seated pain for low back, we can use infrared laser with the intensity of 3 to 5 joules per centimeter square. If the condition is tennis elbow, then we can use red visible light with the intensity of 1.8 to 3 joules per centimeter square. If the condition is osteoarthritis, if it is the periphery area of the joint, we can use visible red. If it is the deeper area of the joint, we can use infrared laser with the intensity of 2 to 5 joules per centimeter square. Other indications are shoulder pain, ligament injuries and myofascial pain and trigger points. Respectively, the expected ranges are given here. For shoulder pain, we can use 2 to 5 joules with visible red and 2 to 6 joules per centimeter square with infrared laser. For ligament injuries, which are deep-seated injuries, as the ligaments are deep structures, we will be using infrared laser with the intensity of 2 to 8 joules per centimeter square. For trigger points, myofascial pain, which are deep-seated pain, we can use infrared laser with the intensity of 2 to 5 joules per centimeter square. These are some of the doses for intensity, which you can remember while treating the patient. And this keeps changing with the recent advances in laser therapy. Other parameters are the mode. The modes are continuous mode or pulse mode. We can use continuous mode if it is a chronic wound or the chronic tendinitis, etc. The pulse mode are used for acute conditions or the fresh wounds. Pulse mode with frequency ranging from 0.6 to 300 Hz. Higher frequencies pulse mode are used for wounds which are indolent wounds or the wounds which are difficult to heal, and lower pulse modes are used for granulation formation or the biostimulation of the tissues. Continuous mode laser therapy are also used for heating effect in the tissue. Next parameter we need to remember is the area of treatment, that is the length of the wound or the tissue that it needs laser therapy. the breadth of the tissue and the depth should be entered by the therapist. After all the parameters has been selected and entered in the machine will calculate the treatment duration. Next chart is for the type of application of laser, that is the mode of application. If it is a large wound and depth of 1 to 2 cm, we can use scanning mode of application. For example, diabetic foot, venous ulcer, bed sore and burns can be treated with laser scanning mode. If the wound is in unreachable areas such as burn and wounds underneath the arm, or if there is edema that is underneath the skin, then we can use visible red probe. If it is inflammation, then the scanning mode can be used, for example rheumatoid arthritis or any other sports injury. If it is a superficial pain with large area involvement, we will be using scanning mode of application, for example low back pain. Superficial pain with small spot pain, for example tennis elbow and golfer's elbow, it can be treated with visible red probe. Again, deep seated pain, for example carpal tunnel syndrome, osteoarthritis, low back pain, etc., can be treated with infrared probe. Coming to techniques of application or the methods of applying laser therapy. First point is preparation of the patient. Therapist should introduce the patient about himself and about the laser therapy, explanation of the treatment, its benefits, and contraindications should be explained to the patient so that the patient feels comfortable and agrees to take the treatment. If patient agrees to take the treatment, the therapist has to take the informed consent from the patient. The patient agrees to take the treatment, therefore patient will sign the informed consent. Next point is preparation of the apparatus. Before applying to the patient, before applying the laser therapy on the patient's body, the machine should be checked so that it is functional. Preparation of the part that is to be treated with laser therapy should be adequately exposed, and the laser therapy can be applied by selecting the parameters. For example, the wavelength can be selected depending upon the depth of the tissue that needs to be treated. The continuous or pulse mode can be selected depending upon the result that is expected. After the treatment is over, the machine should be terminated and the parameters that were used should be recorded on the file. Here is the demonstration to show you all how the parameters can be selected and entered in this machine. This is a probe machine manufactured by Technomed Electronics. It provides us with two probes. Those are infrared and the red laser probe. For now, we will select the infrared probe for this demonstration. So this infrared probe has a socket, a cable with a socket, 3-pin socket, which we can insert it on the machine. After the socket is inserted, we have to on the main switch. Once the main switch is on, we will on the machine switch. After machine switch is on, we can see the display where we can select red or infrared probe. To select infrared, we will press S1 to shift and press the select button. After that, we will see the option for continuous or pulse mode. We will select pulse mode by shifting S1 and select. Then we will see the frequency range from 0.1 to 1 and 1 to 300 Hz. We will shift to 1 to 300 Hz and select. The frequency we can enter referring to the recent advances on laser therapy treatment. For now, we will enter 10 Hz and press the select button. Now they are asking for the intensity, the type of intensity we would like to use. We will use joules per centimeter square. Then machine asks us to enter the tissue length that needs the treatment. So for now we'll select 2 cm and width of 1 cm. Then we need to enter the dose. For tissue wound healing, we will enter 1.5 joules per centimeter square. Then they'll ask for tissue depth. We will select 1 cm. Now the machine has automatically calculated the time. And then you can see here the 1 minute treatment duration has been calculated by the machine, and that is a pulse type of frequency. Now if we want to heal the tissue of 1 cm by 2 cm, then we have to divide the tissue into 4 points where we will be applying the laser beams. If the treatment time calculated is 1 minute, we will divide it by 4 because we have selected 4 points on the periphery of the wound. If we divide 1 minute by 4 points, we will get 15 seconds. So we'll apply laser therapy on this each points for 15 seconds. 15 seconds for point 1, 15 seconds for point 2, point 3 and point 4. Then there will be biostimulation of the tissue and new growth will be arising from the periphery of the wound. Now let's select the red probe, red light laser. For this, we'll press the continuous mode, select the continuous mode. Here we don't have to enter any frequencies. Then we'll select the intensity joules per centimeter square, enter the same parameters for area, 2 cm for length, 1 cm width, and the intensity of 1.5 joules per centimeter square for wound healing. Same parameter, 1 cm depth. Now here you can see for red light probe, it has calculated 4 minutes because we have selected continuous mode as well. And you can see the beams are in continuous mode. There is no pulsation of the beams. If you want to see the pulsation of the beams, we have to enter the pulse mode. Now let's check the pulse mode with the frequency of 2 Hz. So you can see, the lesser the frequency, the slower the beam. Once the parameters are selected, we can apply treatment.